I'll see you this exam. Anyone prepares exam? No one?
Yes.
Yeah. Oh. Let's start one by one.
Yeah.
Okay, question number one. All C short document, correct? Yes. Okay. Question number two, keep it now. Question number two. Question number three.
What is question number one?
Question number one, C.
C, okay.
Question number three. Share with us, please. Only two sharing with me. Where is other, please?
Hey, you need to reply for three or two?
Number three.
Number three is A.
Okay. Okay. Correct, number C is A. Is tricky questions. Just ask for.
Just sorry again, what was number two? The answer?
Two we will solve at the end.
Okay.
If the problem
okay.
needs the steps, we will solve at the end.
Okay. Okay.
Question number three, just to give you the value and to give you the definition of the required.
Yeah.
Which is the same actually. This trick.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, question number four is keep it now.
Okay.
Question number five.
B.
Yes, correct. Question number five is B. B for book. Question number six.
B.
Question number six. Okay. Hello. Yes, 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 like this. Share with me. Okay. Almost all going to the correct answer. Question number six is not all going to the correct answer, no. Question number six is D.
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 One and four, right? The first end of fourth.
D with daddy. D for daddy.
Ready, yeah, okay.
Okay. Turbulent, this used to be well mixed actually.
Yeah.
Question number seven, we will solve it today during session. It's
okay.
Solved by bumps and losses, something like this, but it's covered today during session. Also, I think we have two problems more we will solve it also today in the session. Question number 8.
D.
Question number 8, actually, the correct answer is C. Yes, excellent. Question number 9. No one answered. Okay. Question number 10, we will solve it also today. Question number 11.
D.
B or Z?
D for daddy.
D for daddy. Other engineer, please agree for this answer or not agree? Where are you? Okay. Okay, actually, the question number 11, answer is D for daddy. D for daddy. Question number 12. Question number 12.
B for bubble.
Same like so bubble. Okay. Anyone have another idea? Other idea? Yes, the correct answer is D, is B for subbubble. Question number 13.
13?
13.
A. 13 A.
Okay, correct. 14.
14 is false, B.
Correct. 15.
B.
All agree for answer, or anyone have another option? Why no one? No, don't reply me. Reply me, please. Interact with me, please.
Mm-hmm.
Read questions. Give me what's your opinion? What is the answer you suggest?
B.
Anyone, can you tell me why?
Because height is varying, the level of water is varying, but the diameter is uniform.
Yeah, I agree, same.
So height is varying, so the velocity is
varying
crossing on the crossing and the
cross the cross section is same.
Cross section same, but the velocity mapping is a cross section is different according to the height change. Correct?
Yeah. Correct.
Yes, correct. So number 15 is B. Number 16.
Number 15 is
B. B for baby.
B for baby.
Okay. Yes, yes.
Number 16 is B.
B number also 16.
No, 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 no. This is D, unsteady.
B and D is unsteady actually.
Yeah, unsteady and non-uniform because there is a diameter which is varying.
Yeah. Correct, great. Yes. So number 16 is D, D for daddy. Okay. Number 17.
D boundary layer.
No one have idea. Seventeen A. Okay.
17A.
Yes, A.
Any reasoning, sir?
17A.
Yeah. Any reasoning, sir, for that?
Anyone?
Yeah, any reasoning for this?
Flow is laminar inside the boundary layer and turbulent outside.
Okay.
If you remember the curve for inviscid and viscous flow for classification of the flow, we will see the boundary layer, it is very close from the wall. So normally the flow contact for this or near from the wall, the change of velocity is small. The change of velocity is high, but still the flow is going together like laminar. Oh. This is irregular. But outside that is turbulent. Outside the boundary layer is turbulent. Not all the time, but this is a default.
Okay.
Other, it is not correct. Turbulent is not inside. So it's not accept. Like we can catch, which is not correct, and cancel. So the remaining is laminar inside the boundary and turbulent outside.
Okay.
Because normally inside it is not turbulent. Number 18.
B
for baby.
B for baby.
Correct. Number 19.
C.
Okay. First law of thermodynamics detailed with conservation of mass.
Conservation of
energy.
Energy.
Yes. Yes, correct. We will see this one. We study in thermodynamic part. Question number 20.
Okay.
C. You do.
We have one answer, C.
C. Sorry, B.
Last answer. We have B and we have C options.
Yes.
Okay. Anyone need to add answer?
Yeah.
Okay, finally, the answer for number 20 is C. Answer C. Is C. Yes. So we're going back to the questions to check the numerical questions. We don't solve it. We found question number 10, and this one we'll see the answer during session today. Nine, we can solve it now. Okay. Actually, is it nine here? Mm-hmm. Write it now for the answer. Difference in pressure across air bubble of diameter 0.01 merged in water surface tension. This surface tension sigma.
Uh-huh.
And this is the diameter. So the required is difference in pressure delta B. But it should be given the equation for that. Delta B actually is equal to, I think, two sigma over R or four sigma over R. I don't remember. But by the way, this sigma is 0.072. Air bubble. R is
0.005.
1 divided by 2. Because this one is diameter.
Yeah.
But here is the radius. So we divide by 2 to obtain the radius. Think it's the answer.
144.
No. No, 288.
Sorry, 0.072.
Maybe is it 4 sigma over R? I didn't remember.
Okay. 0.0005 equals to, 288.
As it is? As it is 288?
288.
No, as it is 144.
288. Newton meter square. Newton meter square. Yeah.
Divide times 2 divide over 144. So this one is 2 here above. Okay, control. This two. Here for two. We forget this two actually.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay now.
Yeah, 288.
Yeah, 288.
Okay. Remaining question number 10.
Wow. What are the red divisions?
Question number 7. Also, you solve it during session today. Question number, what else?
Number four.
Yeah. Yes, number four also, you'll solve it here during session. So the exact remaining is?
Number two,
yes. This is the remaining one. Okay, start here to solve it. Steady flow through a nozzle. The flow velocity on a nozzle axis. X is given by V equal U naught. 1 plus cx over l. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
X is the distance along the x of the nozzle from its L plane, and L is the length of the nozzle, total length, time required for a particle, for a fluid particle on the x to travel from the L to the exit plane of the nozzle is, so the required is time to travel from this point to this point. The only way to get the time here, you need to get a relation between the time and the velocity. The only relation between these two is the meaning of velocity. Velocity definition is equal to what? The change of displacement
upon time.
By time.
Time.
Correct?
Correct.
Yeah.
So in this case, velocity we have here is u naught 1 plus cx over l equal to x by dt.
Dt.
Next step, we have here differentiation. So to get t, we need to make integration. Okay, to start the integration, first step, we need to make a separation for variables. We have two variables, x and t. So anything related for x going with x, anything related for t, keep it with t. Here, almost all this related to x. So I will write 1 over u naught 1 plus cx over l dx equal dt. I put this dt other side, and I put this other side here. We found something like this. Correct or not?
Correct.
Okay, what else? Then going to make integration. So if I start integration, to get here, you can start here. Okay, integrate this one and integrate this one. What is the integration limit for this? From zero to time t required, and from this one, from zero to L.
L.
Correct? So the integration. First one here, 1 divided by u naught. U naught is a constant actually, so 1 plus cx over l. What is the integration for this one? I give you something to remind this integration. Integrate 1 over x dx equal to what?
X.
Ln x. Ln x. 1 over x dx is integrated to ln x. So this similar 1 over something, which is a variable including here, but this is not x alone, this some x with some coefficient. But by the way, we can consider as a one variable z, y. So 1 over something dx integration for this one is ln for this something, correct?
Yeah.
So 1 over u naught is constant. And this integration will be ln 1 plus cx over l. But the integration is not totally finished. Should be if the x have a coefficient like 3 over l like this, should be multiplied the outside the coefficient, the reciprocal for this coefficient. So we should multiply here this coefficient of x 3 over l. So we need to multiply l over 3. Now, on the other side, t it integrate space or constant dt, which is t. This one should be add the limitation for integration. What is this limitation? 0 and l. This limitation from 0 to t, it means t minus 0 is equal to t. Keep it the same. Last step now is substitution. So if you're going to substitute, I will continue down here, okay? 1 over u naught, also L over 3, all is constant. Should be substitute by L first, so ln 1 plus 3L over L minus len 1 plus 0 over L. All this is equal to T. Okay, going to simplification. Here, L cancels L, remaining 1 plus C, which is 4. So 1 unit, L over C, len 4 minus, this is 0, correct? Correct?
Yes.
So remaining is len 1. Len 1 is equal to what? Zero. Len 1 is equal to what? Zero. So put here zero equal to T. So the T is equal to L over C U naught len 4. If you have any question for these steps, tell me please.
Yeah, about the third line, 1 by u.
Note, L over C, len 1 plus 3x over L.
Yeah, this L over 3, I couldn't recollect. Why this L over 3?
L over 3, this is the reciprocal for the coefficient of x inside the integration we get it.
Ah, okay, okay, for that, okay.
We have 3x over L. The coefficient here is x is not alone. We have coefficient. This coefficient 3 over L should be multiplied outside the reciprocal for this one.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
No more question?
Getting to do integration differentiation after a very long time. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah, I know that. So I'm just going to make a refreshment to you. Here, okay?
Okay.
Okay. Close now exam and the remaining questions, three questions, we will solve it during the session today.
Okay.
Okay, going to do presentation. Today we will talk about four bumps. Today we will talk about four bumps. Actually, bumps. Going to general idea first for bumps, and some important notes for bumps. Then going to a set of questions related for theoretical part for bumps coming in the exam, okay? And then going to numerical part, which is very important also today, okay?
Okay.
Starting first by some information for bumps. Actually, bumps, when you're going to classify in two main parts. First one is dynamic bumps, and second one is displacement bumps. Dynamic bumps and displacement bump. Any question? Okay. All hear me? No, yes. Problems for voice?
Clear.
Okay. For dynamic bumps, for the part of the dynamic bumps, we can see some model like centrifugal bumps, like axial bump, and this centrifugal classified to radial or makes it like vertical or horizontal. Okay. Second bar for displacement pump. Displacement pumps classified into reciprocating pumps and rotary pumps, both under the umbrella for displacement pumps. Reciprocating like piston pump, like diaphragm pump. But rotary pumps like gear pump, like loop pump, like screw pump, like vane pump, all this under rotary pumps. Now I give you some main difference point between this one and this one, dynamic part and displacement part. Okay. I will start by the important point first and going to the less important information. Okay. Take notes for this, please. One of the important thing, which I'm coming a lot for that, dynamic pump used for higher discharge and low heat. Higher discharge, high flow rate, and low heat. This dynamic pump. But displacement pump used for opposite, higher head and low discharge. Higher head and low discharge. This is one of the main difference between these two and very important. Second thing, dynamic pump, we have something we did it at the beginning before we start operation for the pump. But this only we do that in the part of centrifugal or dynamic. What is this one? Priming. So the problem of priming we can found in the part of dynamic or centrifugal pumps, but we don't have any problem for this point in the displacement. What is the priming actually? Priming, it is filling the pump from the suction bar to the discharge bar to be sure there is no liquid, there is no gases or air bubbles or anything between the line for pressing or increase the pressure for the liquid from the suction to discharge board. Okay, this priming. What else? Centrifugal discharge is continuous, but displacement, the default type is fluctuating or pulsating, but we make some modification to cover this problem or the type of this one, which is fluctuating or something, is to be continuous. Also, dynamic pump is used for domestic application for dynamic pumps, but displacement pump normally used for industrial application. So dynamic pump used for low viscous flow, but displacement pump used for high viscous flow. Efficiency for displacement is higher, costly, more cost for displacement,